San Francisco is one of the most expensive cities here in USA. And if you want to set up a company here in Silicon Valley, you need to spend a lot of money. So we have here Vincenzo Mitola. Thank you for coming here. You are the business advisor of Bank of the West. We are here.
Yeah, thank you for coming here.
Well, you are working, you are from Italy.
Correct.
And you work in an American bank. How you can help entrepreneurs?
Yeah, sure. Let me go first of all, like a little bit of a story about Bank of the West and why I'm here. Bank of the West is part of the BNP Paribas group. Mm-hmm. So our parent company is a French company, European, with presence in 81 countries around the world. So BNP, like 10 years ago, they decided to start the international department in Bank of the West for foreign people that decide to relocate in the US, to help them to better figure out how the banking system works here. So the reason why I joined Bank of the West is through the international department, to help international people to settle down over here, to understand the differences between the European banking system and the American banking system. So our main focus here is to help specifically entrepreneurs with their own company that relocate over here to better figure out what's the challenges of the American system compared to the system that they were used to in Europe.
Where is, because there are no banks here in the Silicon Valley.
Absolutely, yes.
What is your difference? What is the difference between this bank and another bank?
Sure. Like you can see in San Francisco, pretty much in every block, there is at least one bank. So I understand the challenge that they have to face, people who just get here to figure out what's the better bank. And I'm not gonna say that we are the best bank, I'm gonna tell you why I think we are different from them, and then I'm gonna let people decide what they think. Well, first of all, like I said, our international department is a pretty unique department. If you go to any other bank, they won't have people, international people dedicated to foreign that decide to relocate over here. We are unique for a certain point because we are international ourselves. We are 15 people, and each of us is from a different countries around the world. We speak more than 10 different languages, so also the language barrier is another problem for us. And coming from different countries, we also understand the cultural background of the person. And more technically, as far as banking, coming from Europe myself, I know how the banking system is in Europe. So for me, it's very easy to understand the challenges of, in your case, a Spanish person. Once they get here, they face some challenges about the type of payment, types of account, credit history, what's a credit history, why I don't have one. And these type of challenges, it's very hard to explain them to an American person because they were born here, so they built a credit history when they were kids. For them, it's not even understandable why you don't have a credit history when you are 25, 30, 35 years old. So for me, it's very easy because I went through this phase as well. Like 5 years ago, I came here with nothing. I didn't have any credit history, I didn't have a credit card. And now I have a credit history, I have a score, I'm able to borrow money from every institution. So for me, it's very easy to explain how this system works, how to get into this system. And I think this is a very big added value that we can give to a client who just got here, relocated in the US, because it's gonna be hard to find someone who's gonna be able to sit with you from a bank and explain this. And then, of course, as far as product, I'm not gonna tell you like we are better or worse, we're gonna have lower prices, because for me, it's not a matter of having $10 more or $10 less. It's mostly a matter of having a person that you can rely on. And as far as type of relationship, we work a lot with lawyers, CPAs, real estate agents, incubators, association of foreign people. And I think for a person who just got relocated here, it's very important to build a network. Mm-hmm. And once you need a support, and you know that you have a person that you can ask referral to, you can ask help about other things that are not even related to the bank, I think it's like a big added
value. Yeah, because the most important thing here is reference. If you don't have reference, you can...
Absolutely.
Yeah, you are disappear and you are not here.
Yeah, that's like a big difference with Europe. And it's not easy to understand at the beginning, but if someone explains you how it works, the network is one of the most important parts.
And what is the most common mistake that people do when they come here, the entrepreneurs?
Absolutely, yes. Well, in my experience, I would say that most of the time the entrepreneur come here and they want to focus on their company, of course. So they start to do fundraising, they start to do customer acquisition, they start to close a partnership or at least try to. And what sometimes is missing is the preparation at the beginning. So they come here thinking that they can do business the way they learn how to do it in Spain, which most of the time is wrong, but not because it's wrong, it's just because it's different. So if you don't understand how to do business here, it's gonna be very hard, you're gonna face a wall that is gonna be hard to climb if you don't understand at the beginning the way people do here business, the way you do customer acquisition, the way you do partnership. So my personal suggestion would be get ready before getting here, get informed, talk to people, whoever you know, look for information, trying to understand how people live here, how do they do business here, and then prepare yourself based on that rule. Because if you bring your own rule, the Americans are not gonna like it. If you wanna play here, you have to play with the rules. Mm-hmm.
Advice? Do you think that is advice?
Absolutely. Like, if an entrepreneur comes here prepared, first of all, it's gonna waste half of this time. And here, like you said, this is one of the most expensive city in the United States and in the world right now. If you come here prepared, you are gonna spend half of the time, which means half of the money, mm-hmm. which means that you can stay longer.
Yeah.
So absolutely, for the business, for the person itself, it's like a huge advantage.
And the hard situation for entrepreneurs when coming here is try to understand what is what.
Yeah, I think it's one of the basic concept that you have to understand is the credit history.
Yeah.
That's something that we don't have at all. So most of the people, they just tell me, I don't need it.
Yeah.
And my first reply is, before saying that you don't need it, try to understand what is it. Because then you walk in an Apple store because you want to have the last iPhone that maybe is not out in Europe yet, and they're going to ask you your social security number, then they run a background check and you don't have history, and they tell you, okay, it's $1,000. So there are small things that on everyday life, if you live here, you realize. Once you get here, you think that with money you can do everything. This country doesn't work in that way. So for me, one of the most important part at the beginning is understand how it works and how to build a history.
And you help them.
And for them, we can definitely help them for that. We have like a specific programs for expatriate. We have a credit card for expatriate that help them to build a credit history from day one. So it's like specific things that an entrepreneur or in general, a person relocate here has to do in order to achieve that
goal. I want to change my life.
Absolutely. We have a branch over here.
Okay,
so.
Let's go to the branch.
As soon as we finish the interview, we'll be
fine. Well, thank you so much for coming here.
Thanks for coming here, and
thank
hasta
you.
Luego.